Albert Einstein was born on March 14, 1879, in Ulm, Württemberg, Germany. 6 weeks later, the family relocated to Munich, where he started his education at the Luitpold Gymnasium. Albert completed his schooling at Aarau, Switzerland, and in 1896 he joined the Swiss Federal Polytechnic School in Zurich to be trained as a physics and mathematics teacher. He obtained Swiss citizenship in 1901, the year he received his diploma, and, failing to find a teaching job, he took a position as a technical assistant at the Swiss Patent Office. He received his doctorate in 1905. He created most of his extraordinary work while working at the Patent Office and in his leisure time, and he was named Privatdozent in Berne in 1908. In 1909, he was appointed Professor Extraordinary at Zurich, and in 1911, he was appointed Professor of Theoretical Physics in Prague before returning to Zurich the following year to occupy a similar position. He was appointed Director of the Kaiser Wilhelm Physical Institute and Professor of Physics at the University of Berlin in 1914. He became a German citizen in 1914 and lived in Berlin until 1933. When he resigned his citizenship for political reasons and moved to America to seek a job as professor of theoretical physics at Princeton. He became a citizen of the United States in 1940 and resigned from his job in 1945. After WWII, Einstein was a key role in the world government movement. He was given the presidency of the State of Israel, which he refused, and he worked with Dr. Chaim Weizmann to create the Hebrew University of Jerusalem. Einstein looked to have a clear vision of physics challenges and a strong desire to solve them. He had his own approach and could see the major phases on the route to his objective. He saw his great accomplishments as simple stepping stones to the next step. Einstein recognized the shortcomings of Newtonian physics early in his scientific career, and his special theory of relativity arose from an effort to reconcile the rules of mechanics with the laws of the electromagnetic field. He worked on classical statistical mechanics difficulties as well as problems in which they were combined with quantum theory, which resulted in an explanation of the Brownian movement of molecules. He studied the thermal characteristics of light with low radiation density, and his findings established the groundwork for the photon theory of light. Einstein theorized in his early days in Berlin that a valid interpretation of the special theory of relativity must also provide a theory of gravity, and in 1916 he presented his work on the general theory of relativity. During this period, he also contributed to the issues of radiation theory and statistical mechanics. In the 1920s, Einstein began work on unified field theories, but he continued to work on the probabilistic interpretation of quantum theory, which he continued to do in America. He made a contribution to statistical mechanics by developing the quantum theory of a monatomic gas, and he has also done important work in the fields of atomic transition probabilities and relativistic cosmology. Following his retirement, he continued to work toward the unification of fundamental physics ideas, following the opposite approach, geometrization, to the majority of physicists. Of course, Einstein's research is well documented, and his most important works include special theory of relativity, relativity, general theory of relativity, investigations on theory of Brownian movement, and the evolution of physics. Among his non-scientific books, the most noteworthy are About Zionism, Why War, My Philosophy, and Out of My Later Years. Many European and American colleges bestowed honorary doctorates on Albert Einstein in science, medicine, and philosophy. During the 1920s, he spoke across Europe, America, and the Far East, and he was given fellowships or memberships in all of the world's important scientific institutions. In appreciation of his efforts, he received the Copley Medal of the Royal Society of London in 1925 and the Franklin Medal of the Franklin Institute in 1935. Einstein's abilities unavoidably led to his spending most of his time in intellectual alone, and music played a significant role in his life as a kind of relaxation. He married Milva Merrick in 1903, and they had three children, a girl and two boys. Their marriage ended in 1919, and the next year he married his cousin, Elsa Lowenthal, who died in 1936. He passed away on April 18, 1955, in Princeton, New Jersey.
Albert Einstein, German-born physicist who developed the special and general theories of relativity, and was awarded the Nobel Prize in Physics in 1921 for his explanation of the photoelectric effect. Einstein is often regarded as the most important physicist of the 20th century. Einstein's parents were middle-class, secular Jews. His father, Hermann Einstein, was a featherbed dealer and eventually operated a somewhat successful electrochemical manufacturer. The family was run by his mother, the former Pauline Koch. He had one sister, Maria, who was born 2 years after Albert. Einstein would later remark that two wonders had a profound impact on his early years. The first was his meeting with a compass when he was 5 years old, He was perplexed by the fact that unseen forces may deflect the needle. This would spark a lifelong obsession with unseen powers. At the age of 12, he found a book on geometry, which he devoured, referring to it as his holy little geometry book. At the age of 12, Einstein became extremely religious, even writing many songs in honor of God and reciting religious tunes on the way to school. However, this started to alter once he discovered scientific literature that questioned his religious views. This challenge to established authority left an indelible mark. Einstein often felt out of place and victimized at the Luitpold Gymnasium by a Prussian-style educational system that appeared to discourage innovation and inventiveness. One of his teachers even warned him he'd never amount to anything. Another significant influence on Einstein was Max Talmud, a young medical student who often dined at the Einstein family. Talmud served as an informal instructor to Einstein, teaching him to higher mathematics and philosophy. When Einstein was 16 years old, a watershed moment happened. Talmud had already exposed him to Aaron Bernstein's Naturwissenschaftliche Volksbücher, a children's science series in which the author envisioned riding beside electricity passing through a telegraph line. What would a light beam look like if you could run alongside it? Was the question that would consume Einstein's mind for the next 10 years. If light were a wave, the light beam should seem immobile, as if it were a frozen wave. Even as a toddler, he was aware that stationary light waves had never been seen, creating a contradiction. At the same time, Einstein published his first scientific work. Einstein's schooling was hampered by his father's recurrent financial failures. After his business was denied a major contract to electrify the city of Munich in 1894, Hermann Einstein relocated to Milan to work with a cousin. Einstein was sent to a boarding home in Munich to continue his studies. When Einstein reached 16, he was alone, unhappy, and repulsed by the thought of military service. He ran away 6 months later and appeared on the doorstep of his startled parents. His parents recognized the significant difficulties he was facing as a high school dropout and draft evader with no job skills. His chances did not seem to be bright. Fortunately, Einstein could apply without a high school diploma to the Zurich Polytechnic School in Zurich. His grades showed that he excelled in mathematics and physics while failing in French, chemistry, and biology. Because of his outstanding math results, he was admitted to the Polytechnic on the condition that he first complete his formal education. He attended Jost Winteler's special high school in Aarau, Switzerland, and graduated in 1896. At the moment, he also surrendered his German citizenship. He became longtime friends with the Winteler family, with whom he boarded. Einstein would remember that his time in Zurich was among the happiest of his life. He met several students who would become lifelong friends, including mathematician Marcel Grossmann and Besso, with whom he had extended discussions on space and time. He also met his future wife, Milva Marek, a fellow Serbian physics student. After graduating in 1900, Einstein confronted one of his most difficult challenges. Because he studied difficult topics on his own, he often skipped courses, which enraged certain lecturers, particularly Heinrich Weber. Unfortunately, Einstein requested a letter of reference from Weber. Following that, Einstein was rejected down for every academic post he sought for. Meanwhile, Einstein's friendship with Marek became stronger, despite his parents' staunch opposition. His mother, in particular, objected to his Serbian ancestry. Einstein, on the other hand, disregarded his parents, and in January 1902, he and Marek had a child, Lieserl, whose destiny is unknown. Einstein was at his lowest point in his life in 1902. He couldn't marry Marek and support a family if he didn't have a job, and his father's firm failed. Desperate and jobless, Einstein tried menial jobs instructing youngsters, but he was dismissed from all of them. Later that year, his close buddy Marcel Grossmann's father was able to recommend him for a post as a clerk at the Swiss Patent Office in Bern. Around this time, Einstein's father got critically sick and, shortly before his death, granted his permission for his son to marry Marek. For years, Einstein struggled with the fact that his father died believing him to be a failure. Einstein felt secure enough to marry Marek on January 6, 1903, with a tiny but consistent salary for the first time. Hans Albert and Eduard, their children, were born in Bern in 1904 and 1910, respectively. In retrospect, Einstein's position in the patent office was a boon. He'd complete examining patent applications fast, giving him time to fantasize about the vision that had haunted him since he was 16. What if you were to run beside a light beam? He had studied Maxwell's equations, which explained the nature of light, while at Polytechnic School and uncovered a fact unknown to James Clerk Maxwell himself, namely, that the speed of light stays constant no matter how fast one goes. This, however, contradicts Newton's equations of motion since there is no absolute velocity in Isaac Newton's theory. This realization inspired Einstein to develop the theory of relativity, which states that the speed of light is a constant in any inertial frame. Einstein also submitted a paper for his PhD in 1905. Other scientists, particularly Henri Poincaré and Hendrik Lorentz, had pieces of the theory of special relativity, but Einstein was the first to put it all together and realize that it was a universal law of nature, rather than a strange figment of motion in the ether, as Poincaré and Lorentz had thought. Milva, on the other hand, had abandoned physics after failing her graduate examinations twice, and there is no record of her role in the development of relativity. With reality, Einstein only acknowledges his chats with Bessel in creating relativity in his 1905 work. There were two cornerstones of physics in the 19th century, Newton's laws of motion and Maxwell's theory of light. Einstein was the only one who saw that they were in conflict and that one of them had to fall. The physics world initially dismissed Einstein's 1905 writings. This started to change once he attracted the attention of only one researcher, maybe the most famous physicist of his time, Max Planck, the inventor of quantum theory. Soon after, as a result of Planck's praise and experiments that increasingly supported his ideas, Einstein was asked to speak at international conferences such as the Solvay conferences, and he advanced fast in the academic world. He was given jobs at increasingly renowned institutions, including the University of Zurich, the University of Prague, the Swiss Federal Institute of Technology, and, lastly, the University of Berlin, where he directed the Kaiser Wilhelm Institute for Physics from 1913 to 1933. Even as his popularity grew, Einstein's marriage was disintegrating. He was always on the go, presenting at international conferences and immersed in thought about relativity. The couple constantly fought about their children and their low cash. Convinced that his marriage was doomed, Einstein started an affair with Elsa Lowenthal, a relative whom he subsequently married. When he divorced Milva in 1919, he pledged to give her whatever money he would get if he ever won the Nobel Prize. From 1905 through 1915, one of the profound ideas that absorbed Einstein was a critical weakness in his own theory. It made no mention of gravity or acceleration. His buddy Paul Ehrenfest had seen anything odd. When a disk spins, its rim travels faster than its center, hence meter sticks put around its perimeter should shrink. This meant that the disk's Euclidean plane geometry had to fail. For the next 10 years, Einstein would be preoccupied with developing a theory of gravity based on the curvature of space-time. Newton's gravitational force, according to Einstein, was a byproduct of a deeper reality, the bending of the fabric of space and time. Einstein eventually finished the general theory of relativity, which he considered his masterpiece, in November 1915. Einstein had delivered 6 2-hour lectures at the University of Göttingen in the summer of 1915, clearly explaining an imperfect version of general relativity that required a few crucial mathematical elements. Much to Einstein's chagrin, the mathematician David Hilbert, who had organized the lectures at his university and had been corresponding with Einstein, then completed these details and submitted a paper on general relativity just 5 days before Einstein, as if the theory were his own, just 5 days before Einstein. They later reconciled their disagreements and remained friends. The action from which the equations are formed is now known as the Einstein-Hilbert action, while the theory itself is credited entirely to Einstein. Because of its mathematical beauty and accuracy in predicting the precession of the perihelion of Mercury's orbit around the Sun, Einstein felt satisfied that general relativity was right. His hypothesis also anticipated considerable light deflection around the Sun. As a result, he volunteered to assist finance an expedition to test the deflection of starlight during a solar eclipse. World War I halted Einstein's research. He was only one of four academics in Germany to sign a statement opposing Germany's participation into the war. Disgusted, he referred to nationalism as the measles of humanity. At such a moment as this, he'd write, "One understands what a miserable species of animal one belongs to." In the aftermath of the war, radical students took control of the University of Berlin and held the rector and other professors prisoner in November 1918. Many others worried that summoning the police to free the officials might lead to a deadly conflict. Einstein was the obvious choice to arbitrate this problem since he was regarded by both students and professors. Einstein and Max Born worked together to reach a solution. Following the war, two expeditions were sent to put Einstein's prediction of deflected starlight near the Sun to the test. One set sail for the island of Príncipe, off the coast of West Africa, and the other for Sobral, in northern Brazil, to see the May 29, 1919 solar eclipse. The findings were revealed on November 6 in London at a combined meeting of the Royal Society and the Royal Astronomical Society. Revolution in science, new theory of the universe, ideas Newton's overthrown, momentous pronouncement, space warped, ran the headline of the Times of London. Almost quickly, Einstein rose to prominence as the heir to Isaac Newton as a world-renowned physicist. Invitations to speak all around the globe began to stream in. Einstein embarked on the first of numerous global tours in 1921, visiting the United States, England, Japan, and France. Crowds gathered in the thousands everywhere he went. On his way back from Japan, Einstein learned that he had won the Nobel Prize in Physics, albeit for the photoelectric effect rather than his relativity ideas. During his acceptance speech, Einstein surprised the crowd by discussing relativity rather than the photoelectric effect. Einstein was also the founder of the new science of cosmology. His calculations predicted that the cosmos is dynamic, that it expands and contracts. This contradicted the widely held belief that the cosmos was static. Therefore, he grudgingly included a cosmological term to stabilize his universe model. Edwin Hubble discovered that the cosmos was expanding in 1929, validating Einstein's prior studies. Einstein met with Hubble at the Mount Wilson Observatory in Los Angeles in 1930, and pronounced the cosmological constant to be his biggest folly. Recent satellite measurements, however, reveal that the cosmological constant is most likely not zero, but rather dominates the universe's matter-energy composition. Einstein's mistake seems to have determined the eventual destiny of the cosmos. During the same trip to California, Einstein was requested to participate opposite comedic actor Charlie Chaplin in the film City Lights, which made its premiere in Hollywood. "The people applaud me because everyone understands me, and they celebrate you because no one understands you," Chaplin said as they were swamped by hundreds. "What does it all mean?" Einstein asked Chaplin. "Nothing," Chaplin answered. During this time, Einstein also established contact with other notable philosophers. He communicated with Sigmund Freud over whether war was inherent in humans. He debated the subject of whether awareness may change existence with the Indian mystic Rabindranath Tagore. Einstein also defined his religious beliefs, saying he believed in an old one who was the ultimate lawgiver. He wrote that he did not believe in a personal God who participated in human matters, but rather in the God of Benedict de Spinoza, a 17th-century Dutch-Jewish philosopher. His mission, he felt, was to develop a master theory that would enable him to read God's mind. Inevitably, Einstein's celebrity and the enormous success of his ideas sparked a reaction. The burgeoning Nazi movement saw relativity as a suitable target, dubbing it Jewish physics and funding conferences and book burnings to condemn Einstein and his ideas. Other scientists, including Nobel laureates Philipp Lenard and Johann Stark, were recruited by the Nazis to criticize Einstein. In 1931, 100 Authors Against Einstein was published. When asked to react on the rejection of relativity by so many scientists, Einstein said that it only took one truth to defeat relativity, not the words of 100 experts. Einstein decided to leave Germany permanently in December 1932. Einstein realized that his life was in jeopardy. A Nazi group released a magazine with Einstein's photo on the front and the headline "Not Yet Hanged." His head was even on the market. The danger was so severe that Einstein broke with his pacifist colleagues and said that it was legitimate to protect oneself with armaments against Nazi assault. Pacifism, according to Einstein, was not an absolute idea that had to be re-examined based on the seriousness of the danger. Einstein landed at Princeton's newly founded Institute for Advanced Study, which quickly became a magnet for physicists from all over the globe. According to newspaper reports, the Pope of Physics had fled Germany and Princeton had become the new Vatican. The 1930s were difficult years for Einstein. Eduard, his son, was diagnosed with schizophrenia and had a mental collapse in 1930. Einstein's close friend and collaborator on the creation of general relativity, scientist Paul Ehrenfest, committed himself in 1933. Elsa, Einstein's adored wife, died in 1936. To his dismay, scientists started seriously considering whether his equation E equals mc2 might lead to the development of an atomic weapon in the late 1930s. Einstein had pondered but finally disregarded the concept in 1920. He did, however, leave the door open if a way to amplify the power of the atom could be discovered. Then, in 1938-39, Otto Hahn, Fritz Strassmann, Lise Meitner, and Otto Frisch demonstrated that splitting the uranium atom might release enormous quantities of energy. The physics community was enthralled by the news. In July 1939, scientist Leo Szilard persuaded Einstein to write to U.S. President Franklin D. Roosevelt asking him to create an atomic weapon. On August 2, Szilard prepared a letter with Einstein's assistance, which Einstein signed, and the paper was handed to Roosevelt by one of his economic advisors, Alexander Sachs, on October 11th. On October 19th, Roosevelt responded by alerting Einstein that he had formed the Uranium Committee to investigate the matter. Einstein was given permanent residence in the United States in 1935 and became an American citizen in 1940, Although continuing to hold Swiss citizenship, during the war, Einstein's colleagues were requested to go to the desert hamlet of Los Alamos, New Mexico, to work on the Manhattan Project's first atomic weapon. Einstein, whose equation had sparked the whole endeavor, was never invited to take part. The explanation, according to thousands of released FBI papers, is that the U.S. government was concerned about Einstein's lengthy affiliation with peace and socialist groups. Rather, during the war, Einstein was requested to assist the United States Navy in evaluating concepts for future weapon systems. Einstein also contributed to the war effort by auctioning off his personal documents, a handwritten copy of his 1905 work on special relativity, in particular, was auctioned for $6.5 million. It is presently on display in the Library of Congress. Einstein was on vacation when he learned that Japan had been bombed with an atomic weapon. Almost immediately, he became a member of an international effort to regulate the atomic bomb, founding the Emergency Committee of Atomic Scientists. The physics community is divided on whether a hydrogen bomb should be built. J. Robert Oppenheimer, the head of the atomic bomb project, had his security clearance revoked over alleged Marxist sympathies. Oppenheimer had his support, but Einstein was opposed to the creation of the hydrogen bomb, instead asking for worldwide limits on the spread of nuclear technology. Einstein was also increasingly attracted to anti-war actions and the advancement of African-American civil rights. Despite his continuous contributions to general relativity theory, such as wormholes, higher dimensions, the potential of time travel, the existence of black holes, and the origin of the universe, Einstein became progressively isolated from the rest of the physics world. Because of quantum theory's enormous gains in understanding the mysteries of atoms and molecules, the bulk of physicists were focused on quantum theory rather than relativity. Indeed, Einstein would have a series of important private disputes with Niels Bohr, the creator of the Bohr atomic model. Einstein attempted to identify logical errors in quantum theory, specifically its lack of a deterministic mechanism, via a series of complex thought experiments. God does not play dice with the cosmos, Einstein frequently said. Einstein's most famous assault on quantum theory, published in 1935, resulted in the EPR thought experiment. Under some conditions, two electrons separated by vast distances would have their characteristics connected as though by an umbilical cord. According to quantum theory, if the attributes of the first electron were measured under these conditions, the status of the second electron would be known instantly, faster than the speed of light. Einstein believed that this result obviously defied relativity. Since then, experiments have proved that the quantum theory, rather than Einstein's theory, was true regarding the EPR experiment. In essence, Einstein demonstrated that quantum physics is non-local, that random information may move faster than light. Because the information is random and hence meaningless, this does not contradict relativity. Another cause for Einstein's growing estrangement from his colleagues was his concern, starting in 1925, with developing a unified field theory, an all-encompassing theory that would unite the forces of the world, and hence the rules of physics, into a single framework. In his latter years, Einstein abandoned his opposition to quantum theory in favor of attempting to integrate it, along with light and gravity, into a wider unified field theory. Einstein gradually got entrenched in his ways. He seldom went far, preferring lengthy walks about Princeton with intimate colleagues with whom he had extensive talks about politics, religion, physics, and his unified field theory. He published an essay on his idea in Scientific American in 1950, but it was inherently inadequate since it ignored the still mysterious strong force. It was still incomplete when he died 5 years later of an aortic aneurysm. In some ways, Einstein may have been too far ahead of his time to be considered a relic. The strong force, a key component of any unified field theory, remained a complete mystery throughout Einstein's lifetime. With the quark model, scientists only began to understand the mystery of the strong force in the 1970s, and 1980s. Despite this, Einstein's work continues to earn Nobel Prizes for subsequent scientists. The discoverers of Einstein's predicted gravitational waves received the Nobel Prize in 1993. The discoverers of Bose-Einstein condensates were awarded the Nobel Prize in 1995. There are currently thousands of known black holes. New generations of space satellites have continued to validate Einstein's cosmos, and many renowned physicists are working to complete Einstein's ultimate goal of developing a theory of everything.